wake up. The boys are already funny today. Here it goes. All yours.
Oh, let's get this party started this morning. Good morning, I'm Jamie Cooper. This is Athens in the AM. Stay weather alert throughout the day. We'll have that for you in just a moment. Cooking Carlos this morning. What are we cooking, Carlos?
Today we're doing a banana pudding with blueberries and strawberries and a little
apple. Looks like biscuits to me.
Well, that's biscuits. It's my version.
Okay, now
it's going to be real easy.
That shirt's got a special meaning for you. Yes. You have a business on the side.
This is my shirt that I wear with Ashley.
Shut up.
Ashley, we need to take this outside, Ashley. This is the shirt
that I wear
for my catering business.
Which is called what?
The Fiesta Express.
The Fiesta Express. Yep. He'll come to your house,
that's right,
take care of your kitchen,
that's right,
and feed you all the Mexican food you can possibly eat within 5 minutes.
Bam!
Over on set one this morning. We can't get Chet of him, D.
Okay. That's the first time I met him.
The man, Roy, who is Toby Keith.
That's what I hear.
That's what I hear. Absolutely.
Hey, what guy's saying he'll be here, Jerry?
I just for us.
Toby Keith's coming to do our
when's
show.
Where's Toby coming?
He's coming sometime. I can
sometime.
Promise
you. Sure. Okay.
Yeah, well, we're talking. Matter of fact, we'll have a surprise later. Well, Zach's got sports in just a moment. We'll see what's going to be shaking here this morning. But again, Gloria's going to have the weather for you in just a moment, so stay tuned. If you're skinny, like some of us, stay anchored down with a brick in your pocket. You might get blown away.
Huh?
Poncho.
When you leaving?
Daddy, you guys are skinny jeans.
Hey, this sports show brought to you by Hometown Market, 5 locations near you. We were at one earlier this week with our buddy Steve. Well, it was last week. We saw Steve down there. Did we get all those pictures for today?
We haven't.
We'll show those pictures in just a moment. I'll be in some of them. Imagine that. Hey, we got a kind of special Judge Jamie today.
Oh,
we're going to talk about narcissism.
Uh-oh.
Some of y'all got a problem with it. Let's get to the weather.
Oh, I do say laughter is the best medicine. 68 degrees out there, everyone. Okay, now, if we've ever told you to watch the weather today, please watch the weather. It could be bad. The weather, of course, is warm out there, quite warm. And then with the storms coming in, that dreaded tornado watch is already taking place. So and that's what makes it scary, the weather being so warm. High temperatures today, 70. So not going to warm up a whole lot, but the rain is going to move in somewhere around 9 o'clock today. And then with that wind, or with that rain, rather, and the warm temperatures, we could possibly see a tornado and severe thunderstorms. We could see some hail and also winds 70 miles per hour. So just stay weather aware today, folks, for sure. And then look at the temperatures after today. Not too bad. A little cooler temperatures.
I'm telling you, winter's over.
It looks like it. It certainly does. But there's going to be one more freeze. Don't you forget it.
Friday show day.
Roy?
Yes, sir.
He's wearing skinny jeans.
I'm saving up for the extra material.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to talk about your show coming up Friday night over at the Renaissance Center. Tickets still available, or did you sell them all yesterday?
No, those tickets still available. Come on. Come on.
There it is right there.
There it is. Look at that.
Roy, what are you talking about today?
Breathing better. Breathing.
Oh,
we are oxygen critters, you know.
Dee, what are you talking about?
How to fail at anything.
Hey, I'm
kidding. Wow. There you go. That's the deal.
Hey, let me tell y'all what's coming up tomorrow. Roy, you're eating pizza.
Of course.
Well,
you can't eat pizza as good a shape as you're in.
Thank you. Oh, you're talking to Roy. I thought you were talking to me.
Not often, but he does.
Anyway, I told this to Ashley earlier. Daily Mail, the guy had a thing with fire. He fixed a, listen to this, Carlos. A English pea mayonnaise pizza.
No.
Oh, come on.
No.
Yes.
That's terrible.
It's the worstest looking. Brad, you got a picture of it.
That was a good. That was a good drunk.
Oh, come on.
It is the worstest looking pizza you could ever see.
Oh, that was a good drunk right there.
To drink a lot.
That was a good, yeah.
To me, it doesn't look bad, but it sounds bad.
So I call Joe Carlidge.
Joe to do that, did you?
Where's he from, Jamie?
We are going
Jamie
viral.
Says we have to go viral with something. So Joe calls and says, I got it.
We're the first one ever. Carlos, we're building the wall. The wall pizza.
All Trump was doing that.
The wall pizza with free Mexican help.
Free?
Yeah, tomorrow.
You can get away with that?
Yeah.
I guess we can. We're doing it.
Carlos is such a good guy.
It's going to have a wall built down the middle of it.
He's out of here.
With that in mind, let's go to sports. Here's Zach.
Hey, welcome to ZTV 11 Sports, brought to you by KFC, best fried chicken in Athens and Limestone County. Also, go to Herbs and More for any of your health care needs. Go see Abby for the manager special. Text H4M to 22828.
Don't add limb nothing, Zach.
They'll give y'all the know-how of what's going on at Herbs and More.
He only does it daily.
Hey, Jonathan Allen, he's up there at the combine this week, and he is trying to do his best. And a lot of people have him project his top five pick. And if anybody hasn't gone to that Players Tribune article, that's a must read for every recruit going to Alabama. That was the best article. He gave a little insight about Coach Saban and what they said at the end. So go do it. Hey, tough luck for the Madison Academy boys in the state tournament yesterday, Final Four. They got beat 75-66 in double overtime. And the Madison Academy girls won 68-24 and will play number one Deschner. Scottsboro is expected, Jamie, to hire former Alabama quarterback and Scottsboro native Don Jacobs as their new head coach, who will be replacing the Auburn quarterback, Patrick Nix.
Where's Nix going?
Where's Nix? Nix went to somewhere in Birmingham.
Okay.
They ain't got about 50 schools down there.
Hey, Auburn started practice yesterday. There's four guys already no longer on the team. DB Markel Boston, D lineman Cameron Tony, Deion Nix, and Stephen Davis Jr. And also Sean White is out for the entire spring. And Kevin Skarbinski's got an article about Jarrett Stidman saying you might ought to put the brakes on the guy a little bit. He might not be the next Cam Newton like everybody's thinking he is.
The quarterback got a surprise. He's a Heisman.
And Alabama will start up in a couple weeks. Back to you, Jamie.
Oh, is that all? Hey, before I talk about me anymore, we're doing a story on narcissism here in a little bit. But y'all heard what happened in Gulf Shores yesterday.
Yeah. Yes.
Fox News went live with this.
How tragic.
They were having a Mardi Gras parade. A veteran, a 72-year-old veteran driving an SUV or something, plows into the crowd, sober now, injures 11 people of the Muscle Shoals March band.
No way.
Yeah.
Three critical, I believe.
Yeah, three critical. Nobody dead. But here's my point. Now, that's the scene.
Wow.
Every year, but we won't be making it this year because of my knee replacement. However, every year for the past 15 years, we've gone down there for St. Patrick's Day.
Right.
And you've been with us.
Yes, sir.
Paparocco, where 300 drunks walk from place to place, and I video it. Not one has ever been, one fell off a curb one day drunk. It's the only injury they've ever had in that thing. They have no police escort.
None.
I wonder what happened with that. Did he just hit the accelerator by mistake?
Probably.
But I don't know.
But my point is, D, they were doing that right in front of Paparocco's. That's where it happened, right up the road there.
Right, going down 59.
I could see McDonald's in the background.
Okay.
Paparocco gets no police escort. You've got people mainly over 50, excluding Gloria.
Thank you.
Drinking from 8 in the morning till 3 in the afternoon.
It's
walking
unbelievable.
To all the clubs.
And they end at like 3 o'clock.
Led by bagpipers.
Yeah. It's fun, huh? You know it is. Paparocco's overseeing it.
And
you don't
never
have to worry.
Had
don't
one
worry.
Injury.
You're in safe hands with Papa, huh?
Now let's talk about me. What we got?
Of course.
And today's photo, that's me on the right. That's Joe Hines. Joe from Daddy's.
That's
you all, right?
That.
Yeah, that's me on the right. Joe said he grew up watching me since he was a kid.
Hey,
he's
Joe.
Got a Brad Stovall's Auto Body Shop the other day. Joe Hines. Hey, Joe, how are you, man? Good morning. Thanks for watching. And, I said, okay, we'll show Steve's picture. We got it in later.
We should have Steve's picture.
You needed more of him.
You know what happened yesterday?
What?
We were here.
Yeah, I know you were here, but later in the day.
Oh.
I called somebody. Got him on the phone to see if they in doubt were going to come on the show.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go to that interview right now. I had a chance to get him on the phone. He told me that, he was pretty excited about being here. And there he is right there talking about it.
Some time to go by, and he's just quite open.
It's perfect. I know y'all can't hear it, but he's saying, I'm looking forward to doing the show, and I can't wait to get there.
Awesome. Telling you, he's going to land on 72, I told you. He's clearing it out right now.
Let me take a break about a minute early today because I got so much stuff. Carlos is cooking in the kitchen. Later this morning. What do you say we have? Banana pudding?
Banana pudding with blueberries and strawberries, sir.
Yeah, biscuits, too.
Y'all, hang on.
You know him too?
Oh yeah, yeah. We flew the Starship Enterprise.
Judd and Jamie,
I get my
cord. Hey, everybody know how to play. You remember?
Yeah. What?
Wrong answer.
Yeah, got it.
Right answer.
Oh.
Sausages. You asked about them yesterday.
Yeah, Vienna sausages. You can't do without them. Where do we get them now?
You can get them from me. I only expect.
No, but they
got them. Hometown market.
Hometown market. Two for a dollar.
Go
what
get
they used to call it, the nickel dime? All right, here's first easy question. What is Lent? Starts today.
Oh, it's when you preparation for Easter.
Y'all got to speak up over if you're going to say something.
Will you give up something that you enjoy?
It's 41 days led up to the Easter.
Right. But you got to sacrifice something.
Sacrifice something
that's right.
Luxury or that you like. Okay.
We're alcohol free.
Huh?
We're going alcohol
free. Well, that's
40
easy.
Days?
Well, for the month of March.
Oh, the month of March. Really?
We are.
Check back in about a week.
Okay.
Let's check with Gwen in a week.
Check back in a week. You got to give up something you like, though, right?
Check
back in something, yeah. D.W. Dawes is on the front page of the News Courier.
Oh, the beaver.
What's his problem?
Beavers.
What was his quote at the city council meeting?
Oh, no telling.
Residents in the area should have more rights than beavers.
That's Kevin Dawes' deal.
Issue.
Trump last night, what was his percentage of approval?
73.
70, almost 78%.
Ooh,
sure was.
Good.
What was his motto?
Keep America great again. Make America great again.
The time for small thinking is over.
Oh, that was his motto last.
All right. I'm just doing these quick because I got some big, important questions.
Oh, I forgot to.
USA Today yesterday had a thing on.
Yeah.
Taxpayers paid for flights overseas last year for 557 trips for congressmen and senators. What was the average cost of a flight?
$10,000.
$10,000. Roy, you got a good eyesight. Hey, are we Facebook Live again? Remember what I told y'all yesterday? Y'all need to go to work for me. Send me somebody that needs to advertise, and I'll pay you for it wherever they are in my viewing area if I collect from them, which sometimes can be a problem. But listen up. Here's the next question.
Okay.
I only have a few. Then we go to some hard questions. Here it is. Just with you, Ashley. You have mine here.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Out of USA Today, Oxford Dictionary added some new entries. Are you up on this?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Looking at his face? No.
They published, how many new words did they add to their official collection?
10.
50.
300.
Oh, 300.
Here's a few of them.
Words?
What is the definition of drunk text?
Don't text in jail.
A text message sent while drunk typically was embarrassed or foolish.
Yeah.
I've made a few phone calls like that before.
Zach, shut your phone
jail.
So
what
so
is fitspiration? F-I-T-spiration.
Obviously, staying in shape while you sweat.
Something.
A person or thing that serves as motivation for someone to abstain or improve health or fitness.
Gosh. Okay.
What is YAS? YAS.
It's one of the things that keeps flying around.
It says as opposed to no.
Yas. I had that moment. I said yas last night.
Hey.
Yas in some foreign country is the
expressing great pleasure or excitement.
Oh, my goodness.
Pleasure or excitement.
Yas.
But now here's one for you.
For me? Why?
You're blushing, Carlos.
You mentioned it yesterday. Ashley mentioned it yesterday.
You share too much information.
Well, I'm not sure who's turning more red. You or Carlos.
Here's one of the new words, guys. What is a sausage fest?
Nothing but guys.
Oh, I'm not going there. Oh.
Nothing but men at a gathering.
I'm not giving that up for Lent.
What is a sausage? It's a definition in the new dictionary.
No,
what is Oxford Dictionary? Sausage. And for you folks playing at home, too.
Oh, my goodness.
Don, do you know?
No.
Carlos, don't act like you're embarrassed.
I don't touch the sausage thing.
Whoa. Oh.
You know what? Cut the cheese.
This gets worse.
Well, don't cut it behind those curtains.
I'm surrounded by teenage boys.
Okay, here's the definition. D got it almost right. A sausage fest is a noun, an event or group in which the majority of participants are male.
Well, there's a surprise. Never would have guessed.
That's why I didn't do it yesterday. We had that little gal up here cooking those the bra. Yeah.
That was very nice of you. Yeah, very nice. Done it one yes.
All right.
Karen.
Oh, man. Phew. All right, here's one only Roy will probably know. Daily routine of world's most successful men. What's to start with?
Good morning, Patrick.
Start up early.
Chris.
Start your day with the Bible.
Get up at what time?
Get up early.
Probably 4:30.
4:15.
Close enough. 5 o'clock, wake up. What's next?
Go to the bathroom.
Get a drink.
Go to the... take care of your daily
business. Exercise at 5:30.
I was right. Yeah, there you go.
I guess meditate would be the same as reading a Bible.
Sure. That's good.
And then 6:30, read.
Yep. 30 minutes. They got a little out of order. You always read your Bible first.
That's what we should.
Well, it's got meditate and then read. A lot of them read motivational books, and they read, average read. They kind of like me, read two or three books.
But God said put him first.
Breakfast at what time?
6.
About 7:30.
7 o'clock. What time do they get to work?
7:45, 7:30, 7:45.
How come ain't none of us successful like they are? So what's the difference?
Speak for
yourself. I got all these traits, except I don't stay up till 11 o'clock at night.
True.
That's the Nick Saban schedule.
Here we go. Well, why was the 99-year-old Dutch grandmother cuffed and arrested last week?
Uh-oh. It's about time.
They finally caught her.
Why was she arrested?
Darn criminal.
Finally busted.
Was she drunk?
You didn't.
DUI.
Just... DUI?
Nope.
No.
Oh, that's what he said. Right answer would be it was on her bucket list. It was the strangest.
Oh, really?
The strangest to be arrested. The police, they wanted to. She wanted to know what it was like to be cuffed and arrested.
How does that feel, Jamie?
Well,
it wasn't something I was, you know, something I was having on my bucket list. But let me tell you, when they put them cuffs on you behind your back.
Is that a bad feeling?
No.
Oh, okay.
You brought back bad memories.
I knew when I got incarcerated, I was about to get some good publicity.
That's true.
You know what? You if I had to go over again, I'd probably still be in there.
Oh.
Times have
been arrested?
You got to call my attorney about that.
Yeah. All right, here's an easy one. A Saudi king is going on a 9-day trip to Indonesia.
Okay.
First Saudi king to be there in like 40 years.
That's awesome.
How much luggage, in weight-wise, is he carrying?
10,000
pounds. 2 tons.
Mm.
2 tons.
Yeah.
10,000 pounds.
That's what it's just luggage.
506 tons of luggage.
Good.
Great. How many pounds is that?
How many people does it take to handle that luggage?
25 of them.
I don't know, 75 of staff.
572 members to handle luggage.
Now, he needs a production manager.
Wow.
His name, here's his name.
Yes.
King Salman bin Abduzazi Al Saud.
Yeah. I am impressed.
Only a few of us can pronounce a name like that.
Salman Al Saud.
He's taken 2 limousines and I never figured it, and 2 elevators, plus all of his luggage.
2 elevators?
To go where?
Gosh.
YouTube just came out with a $35 a month live streaming thing. How many people are watching live stream? How many hours a day?
I saw that. They just broke the record, 1 billion.
1 billion hours a day of live stream.
And we're glad you're all here.
Get back on him. He said something good.
And we're glad you're all here.
Very good.
Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yes.
Crappio.
The
Carpio.
Did not fly his personal eyebrow groomer to the Oscars, but 2 others flew that person over here. How many miles was it?
It's like 7,500. Groomer, are you kidding me?
7,500 or something.
7,500 miles is the right answer. They'll be here next month. If you've ever seen my eyebrows get out of whack, you'll know why.
They're late.
All those carbon emissions.
All right. Zach, words of wisdom. Then I've got to get to this narcissistic story. I got one more before that.
Okay. Stop thinking you aren't good enough.
What a great lead into a story about narcissism.
That lead into narcissism.
I said, what a great lead into a story about narcissism.
Well, that's next. But first, we got one. All right, Dancing with Stars. Everybody's watched that?
Yeah.
They just leaked who's going to be on the new Dancing with Stars.
Oh, no.
I know.
That's why you've had your knees worked up, because you're going to be on it.
Simone Biles, the gymnast, is about that high.
Okay.
She's going to be there. And Mr. T. He's going to be in there.
I pitied it.
And who else?
I pitied it.
But hold on, Fred. Hold on. What they asked a country music superstar, Toby Keith, to be in there. He said he couldn't make it, but would send a member of his staff.
Ashley's going to be on
the way. All the way from England.
I'll be right there.
All the way from England. There he is right there. He's going to be the new member.
Where'd you find that picture?
Google.
Porn shop.
Why? I had a beard. I lost all that. I can't grow it on my head or anywhere now.
Well, anyway, congratulations. All right. Our last story has to do with being a narcissist, Don Lauderdale. It goes by your signature, which we had several people in here this morning do their signature.
I don't know why.
Mm-hmm. Brad's the smallest.
Mine's the largest.
Look at Brad. Yeah, okay. How tiny.
That ain't always got tiny. If you sign a name, Roy, in a large deal, you might just be a narcissist.
Now, whose signatures are the biggest on there? That's all I'm saying.
Researchers have found a large signature is linked to those who enjoy being the center of attention.
Say it isn't so.
Me and Trump, just like, all right, here we go. Narcissism is the tendencies of attention-seeking, charm, vanity, and low self-esteem, and a willingness to manipulate others. Okay.
There you go. That's you, buddy.
We're going down here. There's a test. Are you a narcissist, Carlos?
I believe so.
Scroll down to calculate your result.
What's that big one?
All right,
James
score right
99.
Here. Okay. Here's the first one.
Surprise. I think this is unnecessary.
There's nine of them here, and you're supposed to put strongly disagree, neutral agree, or strongly agree again.
Okay.
Strongly disagree and strongly agree is the last one.
Okay.
You rate yourself. There's nine of them. Here we go. Number one.
Number one.
I know there's something special about me.
Strongly agree.
Ding, 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 ding. Right answer that. I'm great at a lot of things compared to
strongly agree.
Like y'all.
Strongly disagree.
What?
Strongly disagree.
You would agree.
Number three. I secretly believe, Roy, I'm better than most people.
Are you strongly agree? Man, three for three.
Not you, Jamie.
Number four, I press on even in challenging tasks.
That's me.
No.
That's me.
I strongly disagree because I give up at the number.
I don't ever give up.
Obstacles rarely slow me down.
Oh,
I agree with that.
I'm
just work through them and go around.
I'm back to strongly disagree. What?
But you...
Go ahead.
What? Oh, yeah.
They change your name. Absolutely.
They change their name.
I'm self-confident, but caring.
What is that?
If you don't believe it, just say what they care about.
What do you care about?
Here's another one about me. Okay, here's another one about me.
I didn't change my name. I
feel uneasy when I'm the focus of attention.
Not you, Jamie. No, not you.
Oh, I'm Ashley. I'm pleased to meet you.
Here's another one. Here's two more great ones. Here we go.
Oh, my goodness.
Again, about me. I mean, I could have written this thing.
Oh, you could have.
I find it hard to enjoy compliments.
That's you, Jamie.
Jamie said, no, don't say that about me.
I find it hard to enjoy compliments.
I got to tell Toby about this.
And the last one is my favorite.
Oh, you got a bunch of laughs on that one.
You know, it's me all the way, Don. At church, this is what people say about me.
I don't know if
people that know me, follow my life, this is what they say about me. I ain't even said it yet.
Oh, it's going to be priced.
I got your theme song ready, but go ahead.
It's going to be priced.
Y'all ready? Last one.
We're braced.
I don't like to talk about myself.
You strongly disagree with that, don't you?
Perfect.
Listen.
Perfect.
Hold it up to your mic.
Oh, Lord, it's hard to be. Hardly
home.
Perfect hardly every way.
I remember when you played that on the
show. I was enjoying watching another episode of Talking About Me. Thank y'all for getting up with us on Facebook Live.
Look up Narcissist. You'll see Jamie's picture.
No, look up Humble.
Oh, yeah, right.
Y'all, hang on.
Did they put you in a cell at all?
No.
I would like to put him in a cell now. Thank you, Brad. All right, everyone. Weather where today? Can't stress it enough. We're already at 68 degrees. High temperatures today, only 70. But with, of course, the rain moving on in around 9, 10 o'clock today, we could possibly see a tornado or severe thunderstorms, high winds, almost 70 miles per hour, and as well as hail. So just keep an eye on the weather today for sure. Tomorrow, though, with the rain, a little cooler temperatures, but not too bad at all. We're going to see the temperatures sticking around 50s for a couple days, and then it's back to that spring-like temperature, but hold on, it will freeze one more time before spring gets here for good.
Cover my plants.
Hey, I remember showing
my plant.
Decatur Daily, there's a shot outside Decatur Daily's got a thing this morning, too, about storms. Y'all do pay attention. But I tell you what, when Abby was little, we lived out on the other side of Hampton Cove before they built it. First day of spring, up against our fence around our pool, snow was that deep.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
That was in 93.
Yeah. That's nasty spring.
92 or 93.
It was a lot of snow.
Yeah, no doubt about it.
A lot of snow. Carlos is cooking over in the kitchen. We'll check in with him just a little bit. Ashley's over there trying to get a sausage fest started. So we'll go from there. He's been with us every day. We can't get shit out of him.
I understand. Carlos got that health food going.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I'm glad I had breakfast this morning.
It's got bananas and blueberries in it.
If you just eat those, that's great.
Or you're taking your products. So what's shaking it, herbs and more?
I remember Monday's first Monday. It's going to be a glorious day, as always, because we have everybody come see us on first Monday, and you do need to also so you can save some money and get started on the best products in the world. Remember, nutritional health care, spelled N-E-W-T-R-I-T-I-O-N-A-L, and then put HC.com. Go check out our new website. You'll be glad you did. Well, we got a lot going on at Nutritional Healthcare, but the reason we got so much going on is because even though it's Nutritional Healthcare and care may be the last word in our title, it's always first on our mind. We are always caring and concerned about your health. And I just love it when people come to me and say, you know, Roy, I've been going to the doctor for 15 years for such and such, whatever it is. And I'm still getting sicker. And I go, oh, no kidding. Average lifespan of a medical doctor in the United States, 56. You think they're going to fix you? Come on, folks. Let's get our act together. Let's put our lives together. Let's support the health of our bodies at a nutritional level, at a cellular level, and watch yourself come back stronger and better and be better than you are now. How do you do that? Let's talk about the five biggest killers in America: heart disease, cancer, respiratory disorder, stroke, and diabetes. Those are the five killers. Today I'm going to focus on one, and that's your breathing. Let's learn to breathe better. You need to practice breathing, by the way. Do you know most of you only take a deep breath when you're sucking on the end of a cigarette or you have to walk up a flight of stairs? For crying out loud, start breathing. You are oxygen critters. If you don't believe me, hold your breath for just 4 minutes. You'll figure it out. That'll tell the tale. Just kidding. Don't do that. It's not healthy. Listen to me. You got to have oxygen. So I had a guy call me the other day, and you're going to love this. He said, all these years I've been working with the doctors because I've got COPD. He said, I've got asthma and emphysema. Now, what is that? Emphysema, scar tissue in the lungs. Is somebody trying to interrupt me?
Somebody's breaking G trucks while they're trying to tell you.
They passed out. They were holding their breath for more.
That's what it is. They done hit the horn.
Must be some narcissist.
Okay, but you know, you think about this. Whenever you're talking about breathing and getting deep breaths, if you've got COPD or you've got emphysema or you've got asthma, you've got these situations. One is when you've smoked cigarettes or had chemical poisoning or something else damaged your lungs, you've got scar tissue. Scar tissue's leathery. That means that it's hard for the oxygen to get into the cell. It's also hard for water and nutrition, all those things to get into your cells. Why? Because they're leathery. Guess what? When you take the MSM plus C, I promise you, it's absolutely proven that it helps build collagen in your body, and collagen will put those cells back together so that they're what? More permeable, more flexible, and you'll absorb more oxygen. Number two, if you've got those disorders, I told this fella, get on Breathing Better Naturally. That's another exclusive patented product by Nutritional Healthcare. You know what it does? It goes in there and it gets rid of the inflammation. You see, when you got asthma, you've got an inflammatory condition in the lungs that won't allow you to breathe or exhale the way you should. Guess what? In just a few days on this wonderful product, you'll start to notice the difference. And last but not least, Instant O2. Our athletes love this. I don't care if they're mountain climbers or marathon runners, they love it. You put 20 drops in a glass of water and you can get up to 20% of the oxygen you need through your digestive system. If your lungs are damaged, if you're in trouble and you can't breathe very well, guess what? Put some Instant O2 in your water and you'll be amazed how much more energy you have, how much clearer you can think, and how much more distance you can cover.
So basically,
check us out
at
Nutritional Healthcare.
You should automatically use that.
Oh, absolutely. Good grief. If you're a smoker, you need to be doing all three of these things and getting on your knees and asking the good Lord to help you stop. That's a disgusting habit.
You're not hypnotizing anybody else for that, are you?
I do.
But they have to want to quit.
Right. They have to want to quit, and I only do it by appointment only. It's $75, but I can help you stop smoking.
Okay, so you still, I tell you one thing, I'm going to tell y'all again. Back many years ago, me and Roy rented a room at the Hilton. Had 85
people. Hey, say that a different way.
What? Yes.
But we had 85 people join
with us. Yeah, it was a group.
Roy hypnotized the entire bunch to quit smoking.
I thought there was something I didn't know.
He scared me there for a minute.
It wasn't a sausage fest.
Who hypnotized who?
But anyway, there's a lot of stuff going on. Roy can hypnotize you too. Oh, look him in the eye.
That's what happened to me.
Sure was. Nutritional Health, NutritionalHC.com.
Sale day coming up Monday at Herbs and More in the Dollar Tree Shopping Center. Go by and see Abby, Molly, and the whole bunch down that way. Right now, we'll take a break. We'll come back. You still here?
Oh, do not forget B12 shots, also available today and tomorrow, 11 to 5 p.m.
Thank you. That's right.
We'll turn D loose, and we'll let Ashley tell us when Toby Key's going to be in the studio. And Carlos is cooking. Y'all, hang on.
What?
I'm talking to Ashley. When you get ready to get your own show, tell Toby to write me a big check.
Yeah, no problem. I'm going to call him as soon as we're done here.
He ought to.
Yeah.
Toby Keith's coming on this show. You believe me?
I can't wait.
He'll almost be the biggest star we've ever had.
Who's the biggest star besides you, of course?
Me.
Gary?
Gary Morris?
Gary Morris, maybe.
I think Toby's bigger than Gary Morris.
Wind Beneath My Wings?
Well, just because he wrote that doesn't mean he's the biggest star.
That song?
I've heard about Wind Beneath the Sheets.
So these guys.
What? What's that about?
Toby's bigger.
I'm just tip of the bit.
See, the production guys never listen to the band. Once they get the band going, then they're backstage having a big time.
Yeah, big old time.
I mean,
Roy, you've got to let
music?
Him tell you the story after this.
Yeah, I mean, I do.
Inauguration.
Some things, but you know.
Can you share that story?
Yeah, we can tell that story right now. Hang on, D.
Inauguration?
Sure.
About the inauguration. You were up there inauguration.
Yeah.
Tell the people, the two or three watching this morning, that what happened when y'all were walking around down D.C.
Oh, yeah, it was it was quite an experience. It was... It's one of those times in history, you know where you were when. I'm watching Donald and Melania
Okay, you're that close.
On a first name basis.
Yeah, you know, we're close friends. You know, we have dinner now and again. We get Kentucky Fried Chicken, you know, because it's about fried chicken.
Yeah.
We were going into to do the show, and it was about 5 o'clock in the morning. We're clearing. We had to clear security. It was pretty heavy, but walking down the street and to the office there, and past these two bums on the street, and we had to walk around them because they just had this eau du jour, you know.
They stunk.
It's a true story. And it was just, I thought, you know, well, poor guys, they're pretty close. It was kind of surprising, but sort of turned around as we'd gone past, and I see one of them talking up his sleeve. And they were security guys, you know, just
Secret Service.
Secret Service. Covered. I mean, they were everywhere. It was, you know, on top of the Lincoln Memorial, there's probably 10 guys up there that were sort of Third World War wrecking machines. I mean, they were serious about, you know, it doesn't hit you until you actually see it and you're exposed to it. Mm-hmm. It just. It's one of those.
He said he took his picture from the Lincoln Memorial, and then the policeman said what to you?
Yeah, you know. Because I've never been to the Lincoln Memorial, so I'm standing in front of the Lincoln Memorial. I asked the Secret Service guy if I could have a picture taken, and he said, well, yeah. So I took the picture, and he said, do you know how lucky you are? I said, well, no, not really. He said, do you know how many times people can be up here by themselves and have a picture with a memorial? Yeah. You know, you just don't realize those yeah. moments. But and then you see, you know, 18-inch bulletproof glass in front of the president and his family, and, you know, it just starts to hit you. When you're not exposed to it every day, we can live in that sort of anonymity, except for you. I mean, you're the famous guy.
I
mean,
I don't like talking about myself.
We don't need any bulletproof glass. Right. But yeah.
But he has a bulletproof Hummer. That's the reason reason he drives.
He's got it. Loaded.
What's your subject, D?
How to fail at anything.
Everybody. Put it there.
So much stuff is written about how to succeed. I decided, let's figure out what it takes to fail at anything.
Well, that's easy.
How do you fail? Give me
a whole lot of stuff.
I got a book full of that.
Yes. Of how to fail at anything?
I'm the only guy I know that's on the climb down the ladder of success.
I've got it. I've broken it down into three steps.
What are they?
You ready?
I've probably mastered them all.
Blame others.
Yeah, there you go.
She's holding me back. They don't tell you where I would be today if she hadn't have come along my way and begged me to leave my wife and get with her.
All right, so number one, blame others, you agree.
That's right. And Roy, it's your fault too.
Wait a minute. Number two, complain.
I'm sick and tired of having to have somebody like Abby tell me what I ought to be doing for.
Sick of
kids. If I hadn't had kids, where would I be today?
Blame others, complain.
Blame others, complain.
Number three.
Number three, be ungrateful.
Oh, my gosh.
What?
Oh, my goodness.
What?
I'm about to set you free.
And the truth shall set you free.
Wow.
Roy's favorite line.
So,
well, thank you, D.
Blame others, complain, be ungrateful.
It's a shame you can't stay.
Now, of you who are into politics, look at the opposition party right now that is not in power and see if those are not the three things that they're doing.
Yeah.
Blame others, complain, and be ungrateful.
They've certainly done all three of those. Yeah.
They did them all last night during the speech.
Sure did. How disrespectful was that? I mean,
here's the part I don't understand.
But he did better than most people thought he did.
Oh, yeah. But here's the part.
I'm getting a call. It's Curtis Giles.
Oh, we got Curtis's picture.
We don't have his picture, but hey, Curtis. Say hi to Curtis.
Curtis.
We interrupt this
program.
You got
that check from us yet?
No, I'm mailing it today.
Oh, man. Curtis.
Never mind.
Curtis is going on a cruise.
Check's in the mail.
No, he's going on a cruise.
We're
going to
help him get there. We're going to help him get there.
Oh, really?
Well, he's got to sell his hamster, his bed, and his TV to go.
And I said, don't do that.
I don't even want the hamster.
Is he going on a cruise? Is he going on a cruise with Killer?
No.
I heard from him. I went to see Killer the other night. The 9:30 show, Killer turned loose.
Uh-huh.
He cut loose.
He mentioned me?
No.
No, he mentioned me, though. So that worked out good for me, right?
Something else to complain about.
Yeah, it was almost packed. That place is really nice inside. If you haven't, I mean, you need to stay.
It was a showcase lounge?
No. Had you?
Well.
That sounded like a yes.
That went right down and you turned on him. Did you see how quickly that
happened? Yes. The poles in there?
That would have been wave.
No, they're gone.
Well, they took the poles out.
Yeah.
You were ungrateful.
Yeah.
You were ungrateful. He was ungrateful.
Complain,
oh, ungrateful.
Ungrateful. Yes. Absolutely.
You know, I have none of those characteristics.
None of those whatsoever.
Okay. No, narcissistic.
Yeah.
Well,
none of that. No narcissism. Hey,
have you been to Jamie's house?
No, don't tell him where we live.
No.
If you did, all and of I this
wasn't,
would be...
And I wasn't in the room that everybody got together to
hit me. Yeah, I wasn't
there, wasn't a part of that at all.
Okay. Yeah.
Wow. It's for sale.
What, the room?
The house. You're moving here from Nashville. That's a perfect place for you to live.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Toby keeps money. He can afford it.
Yeah. I got one more day.
All right, tell us about what's happening Friday night, where people get tickets, and what's your... Tell Friday me night,
yeah, what's Friday night, night we're having a little concert. The kids I've been teaching, we're going to have a concert at the... it's the old public library, I believe it is. Athens Renaissance Center, 405 East South Street. There's the flyer right there. You can get the tickets at the Visitor Center on Beatty Street. Or online, there's an online address there, and it's so long, and my eyesight can't even read it. So,
but you had it memorized.
But I had it. Yeah. Well,
hey,
I should
have. Hey, walk in front of the camera. Go ahead and make it.
Wow. Well, that's it. Beat up on the immigrant.
Don't you?
I got it. No, that's it.
Don't you love live TV?
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you, Melania.
Oh,
now y'all have top entertainment. Lillian Glanton performing.
Lillian Glanton, the Late Evening Crows, and
Late Evening Crows.
And then
he speaks English. That's why it's difficult to.
And then Toby Keith's band is going to headline. Metal. There it is, right there. METL, Music there Entertainment Tour Logistics.
On stay
a course
on
that we're teaching.
$10.
$10 ticket. Buy them. Come
for
on.
People don't know. What are you teaching these kids? We'll go over it again this morning. You're teaching kids how to be...
Teaching the kids the background behind a music show. When you see a music show, you see an hour and 50 minutes, something like that. There's an awful lot of things behind the scenes to put that show in place. That's what I'm teaching the kids. The different departments, sound, lights, staging, trucking, buses, international travel, all that legal, immigration. We have to cover it all, and it also has to be a part of moving a show across the country and around the world. And that's what I'm sharing with these kids.
You know... I travel kind of light myself.
You do?
Yeah. When I go anywhere, I can't really afford to go anywhere. So, but you know, I'm glad we had this chance to talk about narcissism today.
Narcissism.
That was an interesting segue.
None of these traits affect me. I mean, let's go over one more time.
Was this not enough about you? And we had to bring it back.
I know there's something special about me. What?
Look whose name is behind him, and you'll see it's not enough.
Got it. Yeah. Okay. No problem.
I'm great at a lot of things. No. I secretly believe I'm better than y'all.
By the way, thank you for having me here.
Are you coming back tomorrow?
I don't know.
He's quite offended.
I feel uneasy when I'm the focus of attention. That's one of my favorites. The bottom three are really easy. I work out.
Oh. Wow.
Anyway, tickets are $10. Just so I can finish off my segment.
I find it hard to enjoy compliments.
You do?
Are you really struggling with that?
And I don't like to talk about myself.
Yeah, okay. Cooper,
have y'all seen my wife?
Oh, there you go.
That's the last time I was down at the beach, me and Roy. I left him. We were jogging.
So are your brothers anywhere like you in this regard?
I'm better than they are.
There's more. Sexiest man alive. Look at that. There's more of you?
Wow. Well, there's other versions.
They're nothing like me.
Nothing at all.
Well, yeah. Whoa.
People really need to go listen to the podcast interview I did with you to fully understand the full Jamie Cooper.
Or they can see it on YouTube.
They could.
Do we want to?
Yeah, you really do.
I thought we had a great ending to that story, but that didn't pan out either, did it, baby?
No, that didn't.
I came up about 12 million short.
Missed it by that much.
The building now.
There's one short. There's supposed to be five, isn't there?
Well, we'll get there.
No, replaced him.
My brothers are working on it.
He doesn't get added. He did all of them. He replaces them.
Man. All that stuff I bought, if I thought I was going to make all that money, has to go back.
That's narcissism right there.
Roy, I thought I was going to buy half the creek, but that deal ended too.
Wow.
Carlos, what you cooking?
Oh, I'm my goodness.
This is my version of banana pudding. But of course, if everybody sees, there's bananas, but there's also blueberries. There's also strawberries. And where's the vanilla wafers? There's none, but there's biscuits on the bottom. A little bit of Cool Whip, a little bit of honey, a little bit of cinnamon.
Cool,
little cinnamon.
Didn't it?
I'm glad you like that, sir. The key thing, real quick, for everybody out there in TV land, when you do your biscuits, you bake them, you let them set, you cut them in half, and then you layer the bottom. And just like I said last week, you have fun in the kitchen, okay? It all comes out right for everybody.
Everyone come get some. You have to be in the shot.
Huh?
Are y'all talking about
me? Of course.
Here.
We're talking about sweet stuff.
We are. Everyone come get a dish. All right, Carlos, on a serious note, you do catering for folks, too. You are available.
Yes.
You come to their home or you prepare it at your house and take it to them, either way?
Either which way. Most of the time, Glow, I'll go to the house and prepare the whole thing right in front of them.
Okay. Now,
I do prep some things, but...
Get some for Toby.
Oh, Cisco.
Oh, Pancho. That's old.
Amen.
Well, at least we can laugh about it, Jamie.
Don't
shorten him. He wants the whole biscuit.
Hold on.
Don't be giving me the immigrant portion.
No, the... here, go sit in the back of the bus and eat this.
Whoa. You just profiled me.
I wish I had the mint, like you said.
Yes.
He was saying mint would be beautiful with this, and he's absolutely right. Sir Don?
Well, and he'll come to your home. He'll serve it to everyone, too, whatever you want.
I'll clean your kitchen. Probably cleaner than... Never mind. I won't get into that.
Come on over here, Ashley. Okay, how can people reach you?
All they need to do is either email me at Carlos Garza, 1020, at gmail.com.
Or you can contact us, 256-603-4848.
All right. Who's going to eat the rest of that this morning?
I believe, there you go.
Lick the spoon.
Roy, you okay with it?
How's the food in here?
Spectacular.
Huh? You need to fix some for Toby and carry it with him?
Yeah, I'll take a portion for Toby.
Yeah.
I'll take it out to 72 because he's landing out there.
Yeah, so he'll probably be back tomorrow with us, right?
Yeah, he will.
All right, well, that's good.
He's on his way.
He'll be here.
Yeah.
All right, Carlos, what are we going to have next week?
Next Wednesday, we're going into the Mexican mode, okay?
Okay.
We're going to do...
That's not Mexican? Hey, don't forget, tomorrow we're doing the wall pizza up here. Joe Carlucci.
Yeah, God bless y'all.
Tomorrow.
When that happens. But quesadilla, shrimp and cheese quesadilla.
Really?
Yeah, I said that, quesadilla.
Yeah, okay. All righty. We're going to get out of here. We'll see y'all bright. Good Lord willing, y'all stay weather alert today. Yeah. Don't watch us. Watch Channel 48, and they'll tell you what's happening to one of the other Huntsville stations. But... winds could get up and not knock your toupee off.
Am I coming back tomorrow?
Yeah, you are coming back tomorrow.
Okay.
Ashley will be back tomorrow.
With Toby.
With Toby.
Another fun pack.
We'll see y'all. Bye.
Bye-bye.
When you wake up in the morning, you know this where it's at. Everybody says he's a real guy.